Ole and I would like to share in this video today our take on what we call at Project A brand intelligence.
We'll help you conceive an overarching model for brand intelligence that combines brand tracking and marketing tracking and enables you to estimate the financial value of your brand. So let's get right into it.
As a part of brand intelligence, we want to know to what extent consumer behavior is influenced by the knowledge people have about the brand. So the added value with which a brand, or rather its image, endows a product is what we refer to as brand equity. And the overarching goal of brand intelligence is to bring all these perspectives together, to measure a brand's equity, its drivers, its impact on conversion, and eventually the financial value of the brand. And how we do this at Project A, we'd like to show you now in our four-step approach.
So the first thing that needs to be in place is proper data collection, or commonly referred to as tracking. Once you actually have identified, but are also able to capture all the interactions that your users do with your digital products, you can then move on to a bit more fancy and more elaborate analyses, one of them being, for example, attribution. Now, that is a well-established concept where you basically try to give appropriate credit to different marketing activities based on the conversions or purchases that they generate. Having this in place is sort of a fundamental step towards brand intelligence, but it needs to be complemented with a second kind of analysis.
The second step is a continuous brand tracking that measures brand equity through key brand metrics such as recall, recognition, image, as well as the variability over time. To have a reliable brand tracking in place is crucial in order to understand the relationship between marketing and communication measures on one hand and brand equity on the other hand. And in order to understand all these relationships, we have to run deeper analyses with a bunch of factors.
So let's talk about marketing mix modeling, which is a well-established approach in our industry that brings together on the one side marketing, or more specifically performance marketing, but then also more upper funnel activities which are more brand related. It's usually based on historical performance and thus can only be deployed by companies that actually have a bit more of a history and can really leverage their data to understand what kind of marketing activities bring what kind of incremental effect and understand to what extent they're affecting the baseline or to what extent they're really affecting your sales, but also your brand.
As soon as the differentiating effect of brand strengths and brand knowledge on consumers' responses to the marketing of a brand is measured, we can then calculate the financial value of the brand as the net present value of expected future brand earnings. To run and to combine all these analyses will be anything else but easy, of course. And most probably, we will never fully understand all cause and effect relationships.
Nevertheless, it's definitely worth trying, since we do have to aim for a holistic understanding of our entire funnel, bringing on the one side more understanding to the value of our brand, but also increasing our ability to effectively allocate marketing budget will ultimately be the key differentiator in every market.
So let's sum it up. In order to eventually calculate the value of your brand, you first have to measure your brand's equity. So the differentiating effect brand knowledge has on consumer responses to the marketing of this brand. And in order to do so, you need to have a holistic marketing mix model of the entire funnel.
Simon and me believe that the topic of brand intelligence will only increase in relevance moving forward. And that's because we face diminishing returns in performance marketing, less arbitrage opportunities for marketeers. Thus, expertise in brand intelligence will be a key differentiator moving forward for most businesses.
So, how are you tackling the topic of brand intelligence in your organization? Do you have a holistic understanding of the marketing funnel? Do you measure your brand's value and your brand's equity? Please voice in the comments and also tell us if you want to see more about one of the topics we touched in today's video.
And see you next time. Warum?
Der war doch jetzt gut.
Der war doch voll gut.
Also nein, der Regisseur sagt immer nur einen Moment.
Was hat dir nicht gefallen?